The verse goes on after this, the judgment. Now, let me tell you something here. You need to listen to me closely. Saved or lost, we will all stand before God. We will either be at the judgment seat of Christ, or we will be at the great white throne judgment.
Finally, Jesus Christ.
After giving account of what we have done in our lives. Those who are going to the judgment seat of Christ, I swear, we will all receive rewards for what we have done in this world. But those who are going to the great white throne judgment, if your name is not written in the Lamb's book of life, will be
in the age of horrible charger. My grandma.
Many times, preachers and churches are like these, yeah. Those words, they are uncomfortable. Why I say that? I believe that's probably one of the best times that we think of heaven and hell is at funerals. Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
Yeah. Third, we will confess that Jesus is Lord. Regardless of whether you believe in Jesus or not, God says it's irrelevant. Everyone will say one day that Jesus is Lord. Some have already done so in this life, but even the atheists. Even the atheist who says that there is no God, the Bible calls them a fool, they will one day confess that Jesus is Lord, because the Bible says, at the name of Jesus,
Jesus calls a finger. You've got to believe that Jesus is
still expected to live long. Night after night, pastor and his wife would put their boy to bed and say a prayer, hoping for a miracle. One evening, the boy looked at his father and said, "Daddy, what does it feel like to die?" The father put his hand on the face of his child and said, "Son, it's something like this. Night after night, you go to sleep on the couch while you're watching your favorite TV shows. You don't know it, but I find you asleep, and I come and take you in my arms and place you in your room, the room that I built and prepared for you with my own hands." The young pastor could barely finish it. He said, "Son, one of these days you're going to fall asleep here, but don't be afraid. Jesus is going to come and pick you up and take you to a special room that he has prepared just for you."
Amen.
My friend, Jesus said, "I go and prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." That "if" was not for Jesus, because he knew he was headed back to heaven. That "if" is for you and me. If you place your hand in mine, then I'm going to put a place in heaven for you. If you do what I tell you, then you're going to be a place for me. If you follow me, then
husband or wife. For God knows who belong to him. And if you want to see Mama, Mama Patina, Grandma, Aunt Patina, whatever the case might be, the name that you know, if you want to see her again, you better go. God, we praise you for who you are. You are the great creator. You are the sovereign ruler of the universe. We thank you so much for your limited blessings. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your salvation. We thank you for your blessing. We thank you for your redemption. We thank you for your justification. We thank you for all these things, God. But we thank you for the salvation of Jesus Christ the Lord.
Sorry, what did I miss? did I still record it? Mm-hmm. Oh, I did. Okay. I'm sure I'm singing. Okay.
You can keep it in your pocket.
People won't go to the bathroom.
Okay, come on.
trying to get me job. I got a thing I have to record.
Yeah.
find me. You will find me. You will find me somewhere in glory. You will find me. I'll be singing for eternity. Where in glory you will find me. You will find me. You will find me. Oh, somewhere in glory you will find me. Singing and shouting for eternity. And you will find me. You will find me. Thank you. your turn.
Yeah.
So I can go see the body.
Hey, person, I don't know.
Thank you.
her breast forever. Her body will soon decompose. Her body will dissolve. But she'll still live on. Ugly boy.
Don't make me open my mouth at the camera.
I'm not doing anything.
It's turned.
I don't know what happened to say when he was calling me an actor. I am grandma. But all of you should say, that one is still cool.
She's still cool.
And my sister Mandy, that was a sickly one that didn't do any tools.
She got lucky.
She did a tool at the end.
Well, she cooks and stuff.
Oh, yes.
So it works out.
My grandmother was 105 years old and she wasn't in the nursing home. Amen. So, how you do it?
Ugly boy.
Hold
up.
What are you doing?
Looking at
all gifts and well wishes. We also like to extend our gratitude to the physicians, the soloists, the clergy, family, and friends who took part in this service, whether in front behind the scenes. Thank you. We have seen a reflection of the Lord, Mama, Aunt Tina, Big Ma, Teacher Patina, Sis Patina, Auntie, Grand Tina, exemplified through the kindness that He has extended to us in this life. Words are not sufficient to express our gratitude to God for your support. We would also like to thank the ministerial staff, members of the Church of the Resurrection, for blessing us with the use of your facilities and in our time of grief. We are truly grateful and pray the blessing of our Lord upon you. Thank you, one and all.
Amen.
We also would like you to know that immediately after the service, there will be a lead pastor. I think the lead pastor that's right in this church edifice. So you go out to church. You can go if you go to that exit, the stairs that goes down into the reception hall, or if you're outside, you go out to around. There's an entry on the lead pastor. Thank you very much. God love you, and we
are. Thank you. We don't have the funeral caller, the death from the caller, to come up.
Let the church say amen.
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 And let the children of God say amen.
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 Pastor Luke was speaking. He said that we all seem to be family in this place. When the bishop of our community, such as our mother passes, indeed, it seemed like everyone in this place is family, including the funeral man, is family. Abraham, the funeral director's father, was born in Arkansas. My grandmother was Miss Jetty Wright, who married to the late C. William Bromsky and had three daughters, a Freedom, Evelyn, and Annie. And my mother was a Freedom. Right there from Arlington. So you are all family. And on behalf of this great family, we like to say thank you for coming and sharing your time to help this family grieve, to help all of us grieve. And thank you particularly for entrusting the final preparation of our mother into our care. The T.F. Pharaoh home is the first and the only African-owned funeral home in the state of Maryland, with services in Washington, D.C., and we are proud to say that we are Liberian born. So family, we never ever pray for death, but death is inevitable. When it happens, you know where to turn. When that moment, it is done with professionalism, but it's done with dignity, respect, and courtesy for the family and the deceased. So if there is anything we have done to help ease your pain in our time of service to you, we say to God be the glory.
Amen.
Following the benediction, we ask all the pallbearers to please meet us right in the foyer of this edifice so that you can be given the gloves and you can help escort your grandmother, grand, auntie, mama to the hearse. We want to thank you for allowing us to serve you in this time. We will make one final presentation to the family, and I will now invite the funeral director, Mr. Reverend Tia.
After the benediction, we expect and we respect the bereaved family. They will exit the church, they will follow the family out of the church, and we expect that you stay in your seat until the bereaved family exit the church. Please give us that moment.
Heavenly Father, you are gracious God, you are loving. You've blessed us with a wonderful time this morning. You've given us your word, you've given us songs, given us meditation scriptures and so many things that we can utilize, God, to grieve, but to have joy in you because of the womb going on. So we thank you so much for that. God, we pray that you will bless us now as we prepare to leave this place and to proceed, Lord God, for the repast. We ask you to bless the food that has been prepared, that it would nourish and strengthen our bodies. Not so that we can use it to share the gospel of Jesus Christ everywhere we go. And allow us now, Lord, to leave this place, but not your presence. Glorify in how we, Lord God, share with us the experience that we have here today. Let them know that Jesus is alive.
He's willing to receive everyone who calls upon him. So we thank you now. We praise you for who you are. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord countenance upon you and give you peace. Now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
Lift up.
Alright, goodbye, Antina.
Paul Burrs, if you would, just place your gloves right here on the...
Slight final goodbye. Bye. See you soon.
I'll follow thee. Child that overhang my work, obscure the light, and all is bowed to me. I've heard our voice above the temple street. I'll follow thee. Although my sight be dim, my spirit weak, I'll trust in what I see. I feel the arms to put it. I'm focused. But I can sit and pray. Pray for sinking spirit and see my loyalty. I shall not sink, dear Lord, and thou shalt let my God. I'll follow thee. The last by heavy waves on the other side. I'm safe, and thou with me. Good luck.
Goodbye, Antino.
What are you doing? Huh? What are you doing over there?
Say goodbye.
Okay, trying to record it all. I can't tell you, Grandma.